Ultimately, it was changed when it went to the legislature. But redistricting is going to be very important for the legislature next time around, so we got to make sure that we win back the House and/or the Senate this election cycle as well, because elections do matter. So I know, talking to some of you earlier, I know you're frustrated with what's happening in Washington as well as in Augusta. But if you don't get out there and support the candidates that support your ideas, then who will? I know it's frustrating. Shelley and I are in D.C. pretty much every week when we're in session. Well, we are in session every week. We're down there. And we're frustrated too. But you elected us to be there not only during the good times, but also the bad times. So it's important for you to get out there, to let candidates know what you feel, what your vision is, that you want the state of Maine to be, as well as the United States of America. And unfortunately, some of those elected officials on both sides of the aisle, but some elected officials don't make it easy to get people energized and enthusiastic about candidates. I was amazed, and I'll quote my colleague, because I don't want to misquote him. And this is the sort of thing that turns the American people off. The quote I'm about to give you. And it's the sort of thing that's not what America is about. It's disgusting, it's disgraceful, and I'll let you determine yourself. It is from my Republican colleague from Oklahoma, Representative John Sullivan. The other day, he was at a forum talking about the budget, trying to get the budget through, what his thoughts were. And I will quote, "But other than me going over there," talking about going over to the Senate, "going over there with a gun and holding it to their heads and maybe killing a couple of them, I don't think they're going to listen unless they get beat." End of quote. That's a quote from a sitting member of Congress. What have we become as a country when our elected officials come out with those quotes? I have been in politics for a number of years. I don't always agree with my Republican colleagues. I don't always agree with my Democratic colleagues. But at least I'm willing to sit down and talk with them to try to find where we can agree and move forward. It's these types of statements from this member of Congress that gets the American people frustrated, angry, and yes, sometimes do things that they shouldn't do. And for him to state that, it's really disheartening, because we had a fellow colleague of ours who actually was shot in the head just last year, and she's recovering. That's where each and every one of you come into play, by getting out there and letting your voices be heard, because it doesn't have to be this way. And in closing, I'll mention something that happened in the Maine legislature before I left office, and the reason why I feel strongly that we have to get people elected at the state level as well as the federal level who has your best interest at heart. During my last term in the Maine legislature, the Maine State Senate, we had 17 Democrats and 17 Republicans and one independent. A lot of people at that time thought it was going to be a nightmare, because depending on any given day, we didn't know who's going to be in the majority with 17-17-1. But it worked out well. And the reason why it worked out well, even better than Rick Bennett, my Republican counterpart, than I ever thought it would, is because at the beginning of the session, we did what we always did. Republicans would caucus, Democratic would caucus, then we go into session. Because for those of you who are in the legislature today, you know, sometimes when you get in the caucuses, you might talk about hunting, fishing, or some other issues, vacation. It takes a little bit longer than it should to get back into the full session. So one of the things we suggested was, well, why don't we just have a chairs meeting? Because half the chairs were Republicans, half the chairs were Democrats. Why don't we go over the calendar that way? It should speed up the process. And it did. It really did speed up the process by having us in the same room together in an informal manner going through the calendar. But the other thing that it did, and it wasn't intended, it just happened, was the fact that every day that Republicans and Democrats were in the same room, it built up trust, open line of communication, and we're able to get a lot of things accomplished during those 2 years because we did sit down and talk and go through the calendar together. It wasn't which party was the worst party or who could outperform the other. It was how do we solve the problems for the people of the state of Maine? And it worked extremely well. Because we sat down as adults, as state senators, to accomplish that. So for my colleague to say that that's how we're gonna get a budget done is disgraceful. Because that's not how you get a budget done. Even though we apologize, is still out there now. And who knows who saw his comments, because it's on YouTube. So I encourage each and every one of you to get active this election cycle, to get out there and support the candidates of your choice, because you can make that difference. Each and every one of you, individually and collectively. You get a lot accomplished. But I'll bring it right back to the community-based outpatient clinic here in Lewiston. It's because each and every one of the veterans groups here in this region got together individually and collectively, and they brought that idea forward and was able to get it done. So once again, I want to thank each and every one of you for all that you have been doing, all that you will be doing, and want to wish you the best of luck. And God bless the United States of America. Thank you very much.